Want to talk about an experience I had in meditation. This was about 10 years ago. This was with my teacher. And most of the time when we would meditate, it's usually a greeting and then we go into meditation. And then afterward, he'll say some words, some teachings. Sometimes it'll be during, but for the most part, it was just like a greeting and then go into meditation. So there's no suggestion or anything like that beforehand. This time, and again, this was about 10 years ago, I showed up and it was actually a guided meditation. And he had a cot that he brought out and I got onto the cot. And the only instruction I received was that I was going to go somewhere. The first place during the meditation, I went to two different places. I'm going to talk about the second place that I went to. The only thing he said was, you're going to go somewhere. You're going to go to the past. You're going to go somewhere in the past. My waking thinking mind was, you know, I couldn't help but think at first before going into meditation, like wondering, like go where? Where exactly am I going to go? What do you mean I'm going to go somewhere? You know, I'm thinking in my head, like, what does that mean? You know, it's a very broad statement. And what if nothing happened? That was the main thing. It's like, well, what if I'm just there with my eyes closed and I don't go anywhere and I'm just kind of there with my eyes closed? And I also didn't know that he would ask questions during the meditation. All of it was a pleasant surprise. So I did go somewhere during the first part of the meditation. I'm going to talk about the second part of the meditation. Both of them were significant and both of them had really revealed a lot of information that that continues to be significant and like relevant in my life. I do believe this was a past life. I went into meditation very quickly into the meditation. I started to see as if I was dreaming and my eyes were closed. I was in meditation. But I started to see with my eyes closed, you know, see like I was dreaming. And he would ask questions like, you know, some general questions like, where are you? You know, what do you see? What is around you? Ask questions like that. The second half of meditation, I went somewhere else. He said, okay, go somewhere else. And I found myself, it was this area and it was green. And there was this structure, it looked like a home, and it had a doorway. And then on the other side, the other wall, there was another doorway. I didn't see any doors. I don't know if there were doors on the doorways, so I don't know. I don't know how many other openings there were. But I went up to the doorway, and there was a counter, and it was also made out of stone. And it was like bricks, but instead of bricks, they were stones, like stones that were up, you know? And so I stood at the doorway and I could see this woman and she was on the other side of this counter that was also made of stones, like the walls. And on the counter, so she saw me and I could see her and she could see me. She looked up and saw me in the doorway. And then, I went around the counter cause like the counter was in between us. So I went in and I went around the counter to stand next to her. Part of the time I was like next to her looking at what she was doing and other times I was actually like in like looking through her eyes and she had a couple of like what seemed like some plants, maybe some edible roots or something. They were these small sort of thin things with like plant. And then she had a large piece of meat. And that large piece of meat, she had like a pot and then she had this like pitchfork like tool for the meat and it was like a pitchfork and she was just doing stuff in regards to the food. Yeah, it was interesting. So during the meditation I was able to answer questions out loud because my teacher was asking questions and I was able to hear him while I was going through the experience and I was able to give him feedback. So like he said, you know, who do you see? And then, you know, how old is she? And you know, asking different questions. And it was interesting because I knew the answers. Like I just knew the answers. There was one, I was able to give him a date. So it was between 700 and 800 years ago. And the woman, when he asked me what country, she went right up to me, like really close, very close to me. And she said, Estonia, Estonia. And she said that over and over. And at the time, I wasn't familiar with Estonia. I didn't answer out loud. And it felt almost like my eyes were starting to flutter. And like, it was almost like I wanted to wake up at that point. Cause it was almost like, I was like, what is she telling me? Like, is that, like, I'm not familiar. I don't know. And I almost like my waking mind was starting to interfere, but then I was able to push through. And then I told her, I was like, okay, I'm not going to forget. I'm not going to forget, you know, that she's telling me that what country. And then she was like, okay. So then when I was out of the meditation, I told my teacher, I'm like, hey, she did tell me the country. She said Estonia. And he said, oh, Estonia. He's familiar with Estonia. So I went home and I briefly looked up Estonia. And so it was totally possible. 1200s in Estonia is totally possible. So I'm like, okay. I left it at that for the time being. And then it was like the next day, I think the next day or the day after, I was looking through a catalog and this necklace caught my attention and I just became engrossed in making a necklace. And I was using that picture in the catalog as inspiration. And I wasn't into necklace making. Like, I don't know, that's not something that I was into. I'll buy necklaces. I wear necklaces. I like necklaces, but I wasn't into making jewelry actually in general. So, but anyway, I just became totally into it. I had all this like inspiration for making a necklace. I even went over to a specialty bead store where I could pick out like individual beads. So I could get like exact numbers and exact kinds. And I picked out what I needed. And then I picked out a chain and they had so many chains, like just so many to choose from. And there was a certain one that I wanted, picked it out. And then I got home and it's not like a simple necklace. I wouldn't say it's simple. There was this cloth actually that was supposed to go in between the chain and these dangling beaded pieces that go down. But I ended up taking the cloth piece out, not working with that, and just connecting it directly to this chain. Just working on it, and that was something I was doing for those days. Well, also during that time, I found myself in front of a television, and I was watching some sort of special. I don't know what channel or what it was, but it was a special. I've never seen it since. And what I want to say really quickly is that the television was not connected to the internet. It was not connected to my computer where I searched for Estonia. So the TV and the internet were not connected. So in terms of like artificial intelligence and, you know, how the internet, there will be suggested videos or whatever. It wasn't anything like that. They were two. That television where I watched that show was independent of, you know, from the computer where I searched briefly regarding Estonia. Yeah, so I just wanted to say that part because I know now, especially now, there's a lot of linking of activity, internet activity or whatever, and suggested videos and suggested content, advertisement and stuff. And that wasn't the case here because they were two separate situations. And in the special, there was a shaman that was healing a woman. And I was just connected to that. I mean, that's the, you know, the meditations and stuff that I was attending and all that is all within that subject matter. So I just connected to watching that special. And then he talked to the people that were interviewing him. And he said that he was from Estonia and that there's a lineage that is thousands of years old that is a healing lineage in Estonia. And I just was like, wait, so I never hear about Estonia, like my whole life that I can remember, except for someone in a meditation, someone who is likely me in a past life that tells me Estonia, Estonia, so over and over and makes sure that I remember it. And then a couple days later, I'm looking at someone from Estonia. Like, it was just like the timing, the closeness of those two mentionings of that country and in that related realm of spirituality. I thought that was interesting. And he had it on a necklace. And the necklace looked like it was beaded. It was a very similar concept. And it went around and then it went down. And it was like, when I saw the necklace, like that was, I'm like, okay, wait a minute. You know, like, wow. I did not know this necklace that I had been so into making had anything to do with the meditation and what I experienced in the meditation. But when I saw this healer man speak about his country and I saw the necklace he was wearing, it tied in that energy. And so I was able to receive the information, the message of that whole experience, which was a past life experience, all within those days and those experiences. It all had a magical, interesting feel. Sometime later, I was looking into jewelry and actually ancient Estonian jewelry, just to see, you know, just thinking about the experience. I was actually telling someone about the experience, and I decided, you know what, let me look up Estonian jewelry. Ancient jewelry. Turns out that the chain I picked out is very similar. I even saw it labeled as a Baltic chain, which is the Baltic region. Estonia is a Baltic country. And it looks very similar, and even some of the other pieces were very similar to ancient jewelry. So it was all tied in. It was all within a, you know, like 4-day period, probably 4 or 5 days. It was all woven together. And I thought that was interesting, the way it was from another realm, and the way it came through into this realm, and the way a message was delivered. I thought that was really neat. Years later, I did take a DNA test, and I did see that some of my DNA actually does include, because there are these regions where my DNA is found, and I have DNA from a lot of different places. One of the places includes Estonia, which I did take note of when I saw that, because I remembered, you know, that experience that I had. Now, from what I understand, a person doesn't have to have ancestry from a particular region to have had a previous life in a certain area. It doesn't have to be necessarily. I thought it was interesting that she could see me. She was able to see me, and she was able to communicate. That was really neat, because I'm thinking, like, so was that me in the past? Like, if that was a past life, then I went back into the past and communicated, you know, like received information from myself in a previous life. And she was having an experience with herself in the future. And she was giving information to herself, to her future self. And that's just like so fascinating to me.
The message that I received from that experience, there was a past life during that time period, and I was a woman who was spiritual in ways that are similar to how I'm spiritual now. There's a connection there, because that's something for me to think about what that means. And having made a connection, I'm going to think about what that means, and how that works. How is it that bridging lives and abilities through time, through past lives, like how that works? Trying to figure out, like, how does that work? Like, what other things exist in my consciousness? Right? What other experiences, like past lives and so on, can I experience and learn about that can assist me here for spiritual progress and development, and how that works through time? So it's a lot to think about. It's interesting. It did come up again, because that energy came up again recently. And I'm not going to go into it too much, but it did, it was clearly that energy, and it was accurate. It was able to tell me of a future event. It just flowed And I noticed it, and it was clear that it had the print. And that's a whole other story that I don't want to insert into this video because I want to kind of stay with what I've said so far in the video for the most part. Yeah, and that's why I'm bringing up, like, past lives, you know, information from the past, and then talking about, like, information in the future and accessing future information. It's stuff that I'm thinking about and you know, wanting to figure out. There's some, I guess, some dream work and meditation and wanting to connect with that I definitely want to do and just feel. Because if that's me, then I want connection with me. I want connection with that part of me, with that part of my consciousness. So, our minds and our souls they're attached to our bodies, but they can also become detached from our body, as in astral projection, as in precognitive dreams, as in even being awake and having experiences, where consciousness can go outside of space-time, because consciousness is not physical, right? Our bodies are physical. Consciousness is not physical. So it can move outside, and it can find itself outside of space-time. And so it experiences the past, the present, and the future differently. There are beings that lie outside of space-time. They're not in this physicality where we experience time and space in a linear fashion, where we experience the past feels like it already happened, the future feels like it hasn't happened yet, and then we have the present. It's because we're in a physical state, and we have physics and mathematics that we have laws here on how we experience things. So a lot of times you have access to past events, you have access to future events, and it's when that happens, like, just even symptoms, like when I talk about astral projection, like, that's a pretty clear cut way, because there are tools and systems and ways to go about and astral project. Even just having a symptom like the vibrational state, where you feel a very clearly different electrical feeling running through your body, like, what, that's like game over. Like, game over for this reality. Like, reality changes from that moment on. When you have a precognitive experience where you realize you can experience, your consciousness can experience events outside of space-time, it's like game over for this reality, for this whole sort of story that, you know, consumers and companies and war profiteers and all these other big things on this planet that want us trained to believe that reality is a certain way, like, all of that goes away. It all shatters, because once you're able to experience, I'm saying, even like the vibrational state, like, that's life-changing. Just any number of those experiences. And then it's not like one time, but you have experiences like that time and time and time again, and you're able to confirm them and they're accurate. It's reality shatters in a fascinatingly profound way. And so I decided I'm going to learn more about Estonia. I've looked it up from time to time ever since then. I did get into Baltic Amber, learned about Baltic Amber, and I ordered amber from the Baltic region, and that has really special energy. That was some time ago, and I made a bracelet out of it, and it was neat that she was able to see me and communicate with me. And then the message was carried through into the waking state, driven, you know, through intuition, driven to view the show with the Estonian shaman. The program informed me of a spiritual lineage in that part of the world which may explain the spiritual connection to that past life. It's really powerful energy. It's really neat stuff. So, yeah, I wanted to share that experience.